So let's go straight to the point. Did you and Representative Dan Fernandez instruct Police Colonel Hector Grijaldo to confirm the reward system in Davao, in effect asking him to lie?
I already made a statement that there is no truth to the accusations of Colonel Grijaldo, that I forced anyone, or we forced anyone, to sign any affidavit in exchange to favors or the possibility of promotions. And that is what I said in the media, Karen.
All right, but this is the point, Representative Abante. Wait, I won't let that go just yet. What is your business and Dan Fernandez's business speaking to a resource person? Why would you do that?
He was actually a classmate of Colonel Garma. And Colonel Garma asked us if we can talk to Colonel Grijaldo because he has something to say. So, you know, nagano naman kami, okay, we talked to him.
But what you did was wrong. That immediately put color and bias into the resource persons. What is the business of two representatives speaking to a police colonel who is meant to be under oath, give his testimony? You should not have spoken with him.
No, he was not under oath in the Senate, yes. But when we talked to him, we were talking to him in response to what Colonel Garma said.
No, but in the end, he was going to speak in the Quadcom. They are under oath in the Quadcom, correct?
Yes, that's true, yes.
Yes, so why would you
speak?
No, the point is this, Representative Abante.
Yes,
do you, in the lower house, do you all speak to your resource persons before they attend the hearing?
Not necessarily, but in a way.
Is it the practice in the lower house? Sometimes
these resource persons would request us to talk to them privately. Also, we give them some time so we could be able to talk to them privately. But the thing is this, forcing anyone to make an affidavit that will speak lies to them. We don't do that, you see.
Okay, but he did not say you forced him to make an affidavit. This was his testimony in the Senate. Number one, he said first that Congressman Dan Fernandez put the paper he was holding in the table at sinabi, yung paragraph na yun, no? Yun ang affidavit ni Colonel Garma. Sinabi niya, ikumpirma mo na alam mo ang reward system. In other words, it appears that you were not objective, both of you, that you were in effect influencing a resource person to corroborate Garma's testimony.
No, we're not.
Accusation,
we're not influencing him. We're just asking him, because it was Colonel Garma who actually told us, can you please talk to Colonel Grad, because he's my class.
Regardless, this is not the point.
Did you speak
to a resource person, two representatives, a resource person in private without his lawyer? Did you do that?
No, there were two lawyers there.
He could be able to
call his lawyer too if he wanted to.
No, that's not the point. When you spoke with him, was he alone?
The point is this, Karen. No force was given. The point is this. We did not tell him. We did not actually force him to make an affidavit. We did not force him to say that he agrees with Garma. All right? We did not do that. Oh. We were just polite enough
no.
Because they wanted to speak to us. We're just polite enough to be able to give them the room for them to say something.
Okay. Another testimony he said in the Senate during that conversation, tinanong mo pa, ilang taon ka na lang sa serbisyo, baka pwede ka bang general? Was there a part of the conversation that went this way?
That's a lie. The thing is, why would people believe a killer who would say those things?
But why would they believe you? This was highly inappropriate. Representative Abante, is this. You and Representative Dan Fernandez put the results of the QuadCom in a compromising situation. It affected the credibility by speaking to a resource person privately.
I don't think so. I mean, we will still pursue the truth, and that is what we want to say. We want to pursue the truth on these things, and I don't think that people would just believe a killer telling lies in the Senate committee.
Well, don't believe that the previous government used killers to testify against former Senator Laila De Lima. That was believed.
We're not talking about the previous committee hearings. We're talking about the hearing now.
Representative, if you're saying why believe the statements of a killer instead of yourself, why even use him as a resource person? If that's your argument, you said he's a killer, he shouldn't be believed. So why believe him in the Quad Committee hearing?
We would like to find out the truth. Why is it that Colonel Garma changed their statement? Why is it that Colonel Leonardo said that there is still a reward system? I mean, we would like to ferret out the truth. Okay. Now I just said, okay, why would anyone believe a killer? But in my QuadCom meeting, we invite everyone, we invite all the witnesses that would tell us the truth on this. Now, if they will not tell the truth, they will still lie. It's up to them. We are here to investigate. We are not here to lie.
At the end of the day, Representative Abante, why should the people believe now that what he told in the QuadCom hearing is true, that he knew of the reward system, and in the Senate, he would lie by saying that he was asked to confirm it?
That is already expected. I mean, we know for a fact that anyone that would go to the Senate would perhaps change their statement. That is already expected, Karen.
But why would he do that? What's in it for him? He's a police colonel. He doesn't want a promotion. If he wanted a promotion, possibly, he would have stuck with the story that he knew of the reward system, given the political environment today. But yet he goes to the Senate and risks by saying, they asked me to lie.
I don't know, but perhaps he's there to protect the president. Perhaps he's there to just agree with the president, with the former president. You see, we really do not know. We do not know what is in the mind of any person. We expect that to happen, you see.
Okay, so you've denied it, so it becomes a he said, she said, in this case, he said. But at the end of the day, looking at your actions and Representative Dan Fernandez's actions, have you learned a lesson not to speak with resource persons before a hearing?
Perhaps, Karen. Perhaps in that way, we were taught a lesson. Sa amin lang, you know, we are just giving them room. Okay? Walang anumang coercion dito. Walang anumang promise of promotion dito. We cannot even promise promotion. Who are we anyway? You see? We just want to let the people know the truth about the EJ case. Mas matindi ang EJ case rather more than any statement of any police officer.
Okay, but at the end of the day, by meeting with a witness, a resource person, you have two sitting representatives, you are co-chairman of the hearing. People can perceive that as undue influence. That's subtle pressure.
I don't think so.
It could be perceived as subtle pressure, undue influence. Remember, you are co-chairman of that committee.
Perhaps some people would perceive that, but most people will not. You know why? I'm the chairman of the Committee on Human Rights, and we would like to find out. You see that? Even in a personal way. Kung halimbawa, nakiusap ng isang resource person, pwede bang makausap kayo muna? So, we give way. What is wrong with that? You see that? We give way. Because he would like to know the truth of the matter. But then, magkakaroon ng pagkakaiba ng statement niya. Well, it's up to him. It's up to him. You see that? Kami lang, ang aming lang attitude is that hindi naman kami matigas. Malambot din kami na nais namin na malaman ang katotohanan. Kung yung taong yan, nais niya, pwede ba kayong makausap? So why not? Oo. But you know, coercing a person.
But Representative Dan Fernandez was there with you. Representative Dan Fernandez was there with you, right? Yeah. And Colonel Grijaldo's statement was firm. Sinabi niya, he put the paper he was holding on the table. I believe he said this in Filipino. And he said, this is the statement you'll say. Tinuturo niya yung paragraph. This is Colonel Garma's supplemental affidavit. Just say you know the reward system. Ikumpirma mo lang. Kumpirma mo to. Hawak yung papel. Why would he invent that story?
Who invented, Karen?
Why would Grijaldo invent that story?
Ah, okay. Well, I don't know about him. Perhaps you could be able to ask him, why would he invent that kind of a story? See? He might be protecting someone else.
So you're saying Dan Fernandez did not do that?
See, he is one of those that knew the killing of General Barayuga. Now, I do not know if anyone would just look at his statement. He was one of those that are accused in the killing of Barayuga. Yun dapat ang sinabi niya. I was not part of the killing of Barayuga. What he has said, you see? And the thing is this, kawawa naman si Colonel Garma. Colonel Garma has a change of heart. She had reflection and she said, I now would like to say the truth because the truth shall set me free. Ang nais lamang ni Colonel Garma is that perhaps you can talk to Colonel Grijaldo. He has a lot of things to say. But all of a sudden, he had nothing to say but go against the statement of Colonel Garma.
But that's what I'm trying to say. That's what a resource person is. It depends, you know. It's a matter of, by looking for the truth, we can't influence them to speak one way or the other. Because now he claims, this is what he's saying. I mean, this is what he's saying in the Senate, that at first he refused Dan Fernandez, right? Sinabi niya wala siyang alam sa reward scheme. Tapos, kinausap mo siya pagkatapos. Tapos dito mo na parang, this is where undue influence could be perceived or pressure. Sinabi mo daw, tinanong mo, ilang taon ka pa? Ilang taon ka pa ba sa PNP? Sabi niya, I still have 4 years before my retirement. Sinabi mo, you can still become a general. Doon niya sinabing, I'm content with my rank.
Well,
it means if you say something is pleasing to this administration, ganun ang dating, is baka maging general ka pa.
Well, talagang mangyayari yan, Karen. I mean, people will always try to excuse themselves or give reasons para baka wala sila sa investigasyon, para hindi na maimbitahan yan, any investigation in the Senate or the House, hindi naman nakakatuwa yan sa kanila. All right? So they will do everything they can to excuse. Yeah.
But I think there's a lesson here for two representatives. It's the issue of propriety and being beyond reproach. We ask our judges, we ask Supreme Court judges to be beyond reproach, not a hint, right? Not a hint of impropriety. So next time, what will change in how the Quad Committee holds its hearings?
We are not a court, Karen. We are a committee in Congress. And we are just there to investigate and to ferret out the truth so we could be able to craft more laws to prevent those things happening again. You see? So we're not the court.
Yeah, you're not the court, but investigators.
We're not there to prosecute.
But investigators are also expected to be.
Yes, but we're not there to prosecute. We're not there to prosecute. It is up to the DOJ or the NBI to prosecute whatever they might say. You see that? I mean, ano magagawa namin kung magsisinungaling yan?
No, but you don't know anymore. The problem now is the public doesn't know saan siya nagsinungaling, sa inyo or sa Senate. By technically, he recanted his testimony in the QuadCom. That's what he did. He recanted his testimony in the QuadCom by saying that in the Senate.
That would be true. The thing is this, Karen, no? Nakikita namin kahit sa QuadCom, under oath na yung mga witnesses, nagsinungaling pa eh. Under oath na nagsinungaling pa sila eh. All right, nakikita po namin yan. O meron kayong mga ebidensya. But they still lie. Oo. Bakit? Because they know it's not the court. Oh, they can say anything they want to say. Oo. It might even be, for example, like for Julius or what it is. But they still lie. So anong gagawin namin doon? But we are still here. We are still counting that one day, these people like Colonel Garma will have a
chance. Well, you can file for perjury if they lie. You can file for contempt if they lie.
We can contempt.
They are under oath.
And that's the reason why we contempt them.
Okay. But the issue at the end is this. You will deny it. He insists on it. Dan Fernandez has denied it. But in the end, how will you proceed with future hearings of the QuadCom?
We will still proceed, Karen, whatever happened. You know, we know that in a way, mangyayari itong mga bagay na ito.
But will you now not talk to resource persons before the hearing?
Perhaps, Karen, perhaps we have learned something here that we must do. Never talk to a resource person in private. You see that? Perhaps that is what we must do. You see? Oh, we're learning the ropes, Karen. I mean, we're not perfect people. You know, we can do some mistakes sometimes. But the thing is this. Oh, nakita namin. Aba, hindi pala maganda yung pagbigyan mo yung tao na gusto makiusap, nakausapin kami. Oh, sabihin na lang namin, okay, tumarap ka na lang doon sa QuadCom hearing. Sabihin mo na lang gusto mo sabihin doon. All right? So, perhaps in that way, Karen, you're right.
All right. On that note, sir, thank you so much for joining me today. We'll be watching the QuadCom hearings. Mag-ingat kayo, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen. Thank you very much.